What we know is the problem is not equitably distributed, and that's what my colleague in the suburban area was saying. All of a sudden, we're seeing gaps and shortages everywhere, but it is much more pronounced in our highly challenged, less resourced divisions. And I don't have as much data as Representative Santos. I was impressed with that. But let me give you two anecdotes and then talk a little bit about policy. I had the opportunity this summer to walk through a middle school with a principal in one of our more challenged urban settings. And one of the questions I always ask is, how are you doing on staffing? Are you ready? Are you ready for the year? And he was so excited. He said, oh, we've had a great year. We have had a great year. He said, I had 27 openings and I've filled all 27. And I said, well, that is great. How many teachers do you have? And he said, 50. He was excited because he'd filled 27 openings, but literally half his staff turned over. And I said, was this kind of a year that was exceptional? And he said, oh, no, no, this is every year. This is just the first year we've filled them all. Then I went to another smaller urban setting that is one of our most challenged places. If you were a sixth grader in Petersburg City Schools last year, at no point did you have a licensed math teacher provide instruction to your children. Not a single day. So when we say this is the next big thing, we know from research that if we're looking at school impacts on student learning, the teacher is clearly the key, and we are unable to provide highly qualified, highly talented teachers to all of our kids. So it is the next big thing.